Hello there, and welcome to my arty channel. Thank you so much for joining me here, as I most probably will do some drawing. I will. I've got a couple of things I want to show you though, and I hope you'll have a go at drawing along with me. But I just want to say thank you for the lovely comments, the likes for my channel, and welcome to all the new subscribers to my channel as well. It's lovely to have you on board, and I will answer comments hopefully later today, once as this video is uploading. Today being the 28th of April, it's Friday, and in the UK it's the start of another bank holiday weekend, which means Monday is sort of like a day off for most workers, but not all workers. Shop workers rarely get a day off on bank holidays, but the rest of us, well, I'm self-employed, so every day is the same for me. I just work when I'm up to working. So no further ado, let's get to it, because I'll waffle on, as you know. So I've got a pile of tools here. I've got three pro markers. I've got I've chosen sandstone, caramel and ivory, because I think they will blend nicely together. Caramel's slightly darker, the sandstone's slightly lighter, but I may sort of like combine them with, I'll see how I go. I'm humming and hawing. I'm trying to keep some monochrome color schemes. So you can see I've swatched all of my pro markers. Yes, I bought a set of 96. There's actually 100 and I don't know how many, 60 odd full sets. So I'm about halfway there, or just over halfway there. So I may have a look at what other colours there are so I can fill some gaps in, because I do like these more muted colours rather than bright in your face colours. Though I do have to say I'm having a fun time adding colour to the big A4 drawing I showed in my last video. But I'll show you that when I've got a bit more further into it. So I've got those, and for pens, drawing implements, at the moment I've got an 01 Unipin pen, fine line pen. I've got an 03 Pigma Micron. Let's see if I can move it in the right direction so you can see it's an 03. For some reason I've got a black Faber-Castell Pitt Artist brush pen. B is for brush, not broad. I've got a mechanical pencil. This is somebody's going to ask me, what one is that? It's a Uni Curatoga, and it's sort of like, as you use it, it turns the lead round, so it never sort of like goes flat on one side or whatever. The fact that I hold mine upright doesn't really seem to, yeah, I know. But this is a 0.3 because I prefer a finer lead, and I do believe it's got quite a soft lead in it because it seems to erase well. And the other pen I've got out is my Uniamart Fine 0.4, because I'll show you what I've got here in the way of art. So let me just pop those out of the way for a moment. This is the drawing that I completed in my last video. I got this far, I've done nothing more to it. I haven't even put my initials on because I want to. I'm thinking about adding colour today, which is why I've got those colours out there. Monochrome for me is the way to go, but I also have fine liner pens that I can use to add colour and texture at the same time. I forgot to dig those ones out, but I can look at them and tie them in with the caramel in a moment. I also wanted to show you something I did in the hour or so before, yeah, an hour-ish. It's a bit more than an hour before I started filming here. It's about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Well, it's just past 2 o'clock in the afternoon here in the Welsh Valleys of South Wales in the United Kingdom, in Welsh Wales. This I've drawn and created as a tag. This was made from, and I wrote it on the back, a piece of 3.5 inch by 7 inch paper. Now this, I don't know what this paper is. I've had it for years. I thought, oh, what's in that box? I saw this box downstairs and I thought, oh, what's in there? Oh, white card. And I would have bought it from a craft shop years ago. So I thought, oh, let's have a look and see how this does. So I cut it as a rectangle. Then I used two punches, which I happen to have in my stash. In fact, they're the ones I mostly use. This one is my corner rounder, and it's made by, put it the right way up, Vason Creative, and there are other makes out there that are cheaper than Vason, which have the same kind of idea. and three different size diameters of corner. So I used 10mm on these, so I got quite a broad swooping rounded corner there. And the other one I've got is this one, which is it cuts away the corners to make an interesting tag shape like this. And I use this one here. And again, you can find things sort of like for making tags. I've got one that you can slide a whole piece of paper into, but you're limited to about 2 inches or 2.5 inches wide. So I find those useful. I bought them when I was trying to dabble in the realms of art journals or, you know, junky journals Angela way, which basically means I'm not going to use junk. I'm going to create the art for them and the backgrounds and everything else. And it was one of those projects that got put to one side because I lost my way with it and I had work I had to do. The hole punch there, I just use one hole of a hole punch, you know, for paper to go in a lever arch file. But if you've got craft hole punches, you can do it that way. So that's all I did, nothing else. So I've got that one. On this, while I have the paper pack out and my paper cutter out, paper trimmer, whatever, I cut some pieces of card. This card that is 5 inches by 7 inches, 5 by 7, which in centimeters, I'll tell you what the centimeters are, it's about 12.5 centimeters by about 17.5. That's because they're the same height. So this one's 17.5 centimeters by, I think it's about 9 centimeters wide, give or take a millimeter. The dimensions don't have to be precise. This one, the Pitt Artist pen is out because I used the Pitt Artist pen to colour the paper edge. I don't know if you can see, colour the paper edge in black. And I had some accidents, so you might see some bits of white. Actually, they're almost invisible. This one's the worst. But I know it, when I scan this in, hopefully they'll disappear. If not, I can edit it. But this was all done with a 0.3 micron. And I had no idea what I was going to do when I sat down. I started by drawing this panel and then everything else followed from there. This is inspired by what's called a diaper pattern. Diapers nowadays are the things you put on babies' bottoms. Which oddly, the use of that name only came into use in 1951. And before that, a diaper was a piece of patterned cloth, sometimes a small piece, sometimes, you know, a largish piece. But in medieval manuscripts, they also have diaper patterns, which are background patterns. So this here would count as a diaper pattern, as would this and the others. So they haven't got any shape or form. They're just abstract, often geometrical, sometimes, you know, organic, but they're just background patterns. So I thought you might like to know that. And it is spelt the same way as diaper. So yeah, it comes from Greek, I think it was. Was it Greek or Latin? I was looking up the etymology of it because I like to know where words come from. In fact, I thought the other day about some words and I forgot to note them down to see, oh, do they have the same root? Yeah, I'm curious. So I'm going to be working on these in the future. I may trim them in half again, you know, in half again. So it's, what's that? I can't remember what I said. 7, so 3.5 by, yeah, by 5, which would be quite a nice size. Okay, so as I've got the pro markers out, let's carry on with this one and do a bit of work on this one. Then I may swap over to the other when I get better for this. Sorry, just lowering my chair a little bit to try and ease my back. So I am going to use pro markers for this. This is Ohuhu marker paper. It is not my favourite marker paper, but it's the one I drew on. I have the piece good to go, so I use things that are good to go. Just trying to get rid of some pencil lines. And that's one of the problems with this as well, is it does tend to hold on to pencils. Look, spots of alcohol ink on my paper here. So, let's have a look. I'm going to start with, I think I'll start with sandstone because it's a bit of a greyer brown and ivory is sort of like a pale yellowy creamy colour. And what I want to do is I'm going to add this colour. I'm going to use the lighter colour first. So I think I'm just sorry if I make you seasick. I'm just going to move the camera down closer, but I'm not going to zoom in because hopefully I'm going to work pretty quick. Well, I say pretty quick. It takes me ages to do this. So I'm starting by filling this little space in here with the ivory. And then I'm going to add the darker colour on top of the wet paper from the top. And I'll use the lighter colour then just to blend it out at the bottom edge. So I hopefully when it dries, I should get a smoothish gradient. And I'm going to do that, not to everyone. I'm going to pick and choose some that I do because I feel I want some variety here. Later on, I must see if I can dig out my bottle. I'm sure I've got a bottle of isopropyl alcohol, also called rubbing alcohol, here somewhere. So I watched a tips video to do with coloured pencils this morning as I was coming around. Kind of coming around. I was getting ready to go back to sleep, actually. I didn't. I got myself out of bed. Ish. Eventually. And it was by Kirsty Partridge. And if I remember, I'll put the link to it because she reminded me about, when it comes to using coloured pencils, you can blend the colours easily with a blending pencil to get some blending. But if you want a really smooth blending, then you need some kind of solution. And everyday things like hand sanitizer you can use, or baby oil and Vaseline people use, but these aren't archival. And unfortunately, things like spirit thinners or, the Gamsols and the Zestits and the other kinds that are sold as blending solutions for coloured pencils specifically, even the odourless ones affect my asthma. But she used isopropyl alcohol, and I know that's not so bad, and it is archival if it's pure alcohol. Propan-2-ol is its chemical name. I like that so much. Do you know what? I'm going to go back and I'm going to fill them all in because I've decided I like this. So I can change my mind. I can't take it away, but I can add, can't I? Looks almost like bone. Ooh, Halloweeny. Just remember this colour combination. So, cotton bud dipped in isopropyl alcohol or a paintbrush will help blend coloured pencils. So that is something I am going to try. Because I don't mind using coloured pencils, but I do find it hard to get a nice smooth gradient. Having said that, I do think that alcohol markers are my best way of adding colour to anything. It's just that some paper I have, sketchbooks and things, I can't use them on both sides of the paper because they bleed through. That's why I got Ohuhu sketchbooks, sort of like marker paper sketchbooks for that reason. But I spend most of my time pulling paper out and cutting it down to sizes I like. Yeah, I know. I'm actually surprised at how well this is blending on this paper. So, kudos. Perhaps I'm being a bit harsh on this. I mean, it's great paper, don't get me wrong. It's lovely and thick, it's sturdy. The alcohol markers blend fairly well on it. These are professional, sort of like artist quality. The Ohuhus are very good. They're all so garish. There's not many colours like this. But I do like to use coloured pencils on objects that I can't, on things that I can't add anything, other things to. Okay, so I want to try to bring out some shadow and highlight on this section. So I'm going to go along the edge with this lighter colour first, just to get some moisture into this paper. It's rather warm in my room today. because I've had the heating on for a little while. Oh, I went right up to the edge there. Perhaps I will do all the way along then. That then will make a bit more sense. So I want to come down into this just a little bit, just to bring some shadow in. So this is the same idea as you use graphite, but instead of using graphite to blend it out, I'm going to use this ivory marker just to lighten the colour and just to add some lighter colour down into this section. I don't like working on big areas like this, I have to say, with alcohol markers. And I'm also wary that the ink that's on there can move. But how does that look? Look at the screen. Oh, it's not too shabby. So I'm going to do the same. I'm just going to wet along here. It'd be quicker if I use the chisel tip, but with a chisel tip, I'm more likely to have an accident going from one section to another where I don't want to go. The other thing with these alcohol markers is if you layer the same colour once they've dried, you get a more intense colour because they add. So you can get subtle gradients with just one pen. But I'm going for something that's not quite so subtle here in terms of shadow and highlight. And I will come back with a white gel pen. I am picking up some of this ink, that's a swine, but it's okay, it is what it is. And that little darkness that's there may actually help with that feeling of shadow anyway, so it'll be fine, it'll work out, you always do. I prefer to put the light, a layer of the lightest colour down first and then add the darker one and then the light one again. I find it works best for me in terms of adding colour. Now then, I'm also going to do this down here, but what I'm going to do with this one is I'm going to pop a line of this down right at the edge. Oops, that one's got a bit fatter there. Poor pen control, Angela. But nobody will notice, hopefully. And I will go back over, get some more of this colour down to wet the paper a little bit more again. And then I'm going to use the lighter colour here just to blend it out a little bit, hopefully, or just have a slightly darker shade on the edge. Lighter colours will always bleach darker ones, but I find these are dry, these sometimes dry, they dry too quickly on this paper, that's my issue with it. So I've got that there. Okay. The top, I definitely think I'm just going to use flat colour, perhaps not flat colour, perhaps I'll use the two darker, you know, the medium and the dark colour here, and do some. So there's my medium colour, and I'm going to add dark. I think I'll go to the left and the bottom, and I'll just leave it there, perhaps just come back with some of the lighter colour, just to allow that darker colour to blend out a bit. If I haven't got enough contrast, I may go hunting a different colour here for that, or just come back and go over the areas where I want the shadow again, just to lay some more of this colour down once it's dry, and then it will be a subtle thing. And of course, yes, I'll put some highlight on for contrast. That's what white gel pens or Posca pens are for. I do like having, do like a monochrome palette, a limited colour palette. And if I've got a huge palette to play with, I tend to want to use all of the colours in the toolbox, which sometimes is not the best. So let's go on and do these last few here. I may choose another pair of colours or so to go in here, just to give some variation in colour. I tend towards moss green and pear green and khaki in this set, I must say. filled in quite a lot there, but it'll be fine. I'm just adding that darker colour here. And alcohol markers always dry lighter, a bit like watercolours do. So if the colour's not as intense as I want, like over here, I'm just going to go back and add another layer. It's the beauty of these things, I think. Of course, the ideas and techniques I'm using are the same no matter what medium you're using. Whether it's coloured pencils, watercolour, pastel, pencils, whatever you choose to use. Okay, I shall leave that one, but I do need some of this elsewhere. And what I'm going to do elsewhere, this section, I'm going to use this darker colour on some of these triangles, medium colour on others. I say triangles, they're not all triangles, these abstract shapes. Just to add some interest to this pattern, and then in others I'm going to put some pen lines in, I think. Could do with one. Yeah, not going to get one over there, but we need a couple more here. That one would be quite nice there. I'm trying to get the density all right. If I've gone outside the line, I'm not going to worry because I'll come back with another pen and just blend that out. So that was the caramel. This is sandstone. Like where I go outside the line will determine where I next put, where I put colours. The next shade of colour in, really. And I'm going to leave these flat, as in no shadow, no highlight with colour. I'll do that with pens. Okay, it's a bit in the corner there. That's a bit there. I could do with one here as well. And that looks okay to me at the moment. So ivory, and I'm not going to add ivory to all the remaining spaces. Just going to add it to some of them, just to give some interest. Very subtle. Monochrome and analog colours other colours systems work well, but I always find that monochrome and analog are often the best for me. Monochrome is sort of like one colour with different, you know, sort of like saturations. So, you know, the ivory would have the least saturation here and the caramel the most, although they're not quite the same shades of, you know, same colour that you're layering one on top of the other. But they're very close to each other in colour, so it counts as monochrome, I suppose. Always works well for me. I'm just looking to see. I think I might pop some in there for that one. And that's... I've got a lot of white here, so I'll just fill that one in. And then that, I think, is done. There we go. So I've got that one done. These ones, these little flowers, I think I'm going to use my ivory, but I'm also going to use a colourless blender. I didn't get out, so excuse me while I open my box and reach for one of those things. Colourless blenders just have the alcohol solution in them. They're in the pen. They can help to blend, but they mostly are used for erasing. What I'm going to use this for is for moistening the petal and then allowing it to fade out and spread. So I'll get a paler version of this colour because not so much of the ink in this from this pen will settle into the paper, but it will softly fade out in a gradient kind of way. So that's what I like to use these for. And also, if you do overspill, if you're quick enough with these, you can actually almost bleach the excess colour out. And I tried to do several at a time, so I'm not swapping pens over all the time. I get frustrated with how slow it can be So perhaps if I do half of these, because you won't see what's happening with the colourless blender. Actually, I should be able to do them all and still work on them. So I shall put some colour in there. And here I'm just flicking my pen as well, where I can flick it, because then that helps the colour to fade out as well. Because as you flick, the line gets thinner and less ink transfers because you're not touching it for so long. It's actually a nice way to add texture as well. But I find it useful for gradients. And it's a technique you can use with coloured pencils or other media as well. My mind went to Swish and Flick from Harry Potter and Wingardium Leviosa. Yeah, I know. Excuse me. Yeah, my tonsils are better, but it's left me exhausted. I've not had COVID, thank goodness. But about tonsillitis was very unexpected. It wasn't severe enough that I needed antibiotics or whatever. But it's a heads up for me to be careful and keep an eye on them now. So that if I do have a big flare up, I do get antibiotics. I prefer not to take them because bacteria becomes resistant to them over time. Because you never kill all the bacteria off. Oh gosh, look what I'm doing here. Okay, well, does that make much of a difference? It's probably not. So, yeah. So that's good. I've booked a rental car for 2 days. Or 48 hours next Tuesday morning to Thursday morning, so that my car can go in for its service and MOT, and I've got an extra day in case they need to fix something on it. So I'm hoping not, as my car hasn't been used much this year. It's been used more than in the last number of the last couple of years, with the pandemic. But we shall see, because sometimes the lack of use causes problems in its own way. So I now have, my washing machine still isn't fixed or replaced because organising the car took it all out of me yesterday, as well as an appointment at the doctor's for a regular health checkup. So that took its time. Yeah. So I've had fun and games, trust me on that one. I have had fun and games. Okay. In the centre of these, I'm going to fill them with colourless blender, and I'm going to use the caramel here to give a shadow on the centre more than anything. So I'm just going to put a bit of caramel at the bottom, and then I'll come back with the colourless blender and just help it to spread a little bit more, hopefully. And lighten it that little bit as well, because I don't want it too dark. The blender does that, it will lighten it. In fact, if anything, it's actually made it mostly disappear. So I'll just add a couple of dots around the edge. Because it's wet now, that colour should spread out into the areas that are still damp. So that will give us some shadow there. Okay. This one, I do want to put... I'm not going to do all of this on cap. I might do. How am I doing for time? Oh, half an hour. We'll see. So I'm going to add colourless blender all the way up a diagonal strip like this. I'm going to work in diagonals, and I'm going to add some of the caramel to the ends like this, just dotting it in. I'm not spreading it out far. Come back, use the colourless blender. Oh, I forgot to do it on that one, didn't I? Fine. In fact, I don't think I got any colourless blender on there. Well, I did. It'll be fine. And just let that blend out, and it'll give that little bit of shadow in the corners, and will help to give a feeling of dimension. Luckily, none of the diagonals have very many of these flowers in. That's what they are. They're an interesting pattern because it depends how you focus your eyes, what you see. You might see it almost like flower blooms, or you may see kind of circles. Reminds me, look at that, I didn't put any there. Go back and do that. Reminds me of these concrete blocks that people used to and perhaps still do build walls out of. So, there we go. Do that one. I find doing a number at a time like this does speed the job up just a bit. It shows that I can get nice gradients or shadows and highlights without having to use too many tools, too many colours. These are such tiny areas that it's really not worth getting loads of colours out because you just wouldn't get much variation here. I find this is the best way, especially as I do want fairly bright highlights in contrast to the shadows. And I can always come back and add more shadow later on if necessary. Don't think I will need to. So I've just got this one here to do in this direction. Oh, look at that. I'm going both directions here. Yeah. Around the centre, at the tips. Just like that. And then we will use the blender just at the edge of it and it will help it to blend out. It's subtle, but it's there. And I'm happy with subtle, but there. In fact, it's quite nice to work with subtle colour. So yeah, so the washing machine's not fixed, but I'll sort that out next week when I know when I've got my car back and when I'm going to be home. It's a crazy week. So luckily, as I said, I've got a wardrobe full of clothes that I love to wear. So it's not going to be a major problem. And I need to get in touch with my niece and go, can I bring some washing over, please? She may let me. Right, last ones. Just here. Very vintagey looking, isn't it? I said bones, but it's vintagey. So what I'm going to do around these in the white areas, I'm going to remove this white and I'm going to fill it in with sandstone, which hopefully will just give us a shadow underneath all of these and will hide where I've perhaps gone outside of these. It may be that I use some fine liners to add some texture to this or pattern to it, but I'd like some colour there. I like the white, but I feel because the highlights are so light, I feel they're going to get lost if I don't do something like this. It may be that I go and look at my colours and go, okay then, I want a darker version of sandstone or caramel to use for this, which will give some of that contrast. But I don't want it so dark that it becomes almost the same as black either, so because the black is my darkest contrast, you know, darkest colour, most saturated colour here. Strictly it's not a colour, but heck, I'm going to call it a colour. And if anybody wants to shoot me or set the colour police on me, they're quite welcome to do so. It's a shade, really. So that works, actually that's worked out quite nice, so I'll let it dry. Last one I want to do, I think I want to do this one, and I think I'm going to approach it. I think I'm going to use the sandstone. Is that the sandstone? So I've got this colour here. I think I'll just go over all of these flowers and I'm just going to colour them in with the ivory just for now. I think I know what I want to do with the backgrounds, the diamonds behind. I think if you want me to do that tag with you, show you how I do it. You will need a ruler and a pencil and some eraser and pens and so on, because I will use a pencil to set it out fairly precisely, because, you know, if I still draw wobbly lines, it just means that I get things in the centre and I get them, you know, horizontal and perpendicular to the paper. Yeah, the bottom's parallel, the edges of the square parallel with it. And then what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to use the caramel to colour top and the bottom. And by adding colour, it just adds that saturation. Again, if you remember, if you watch my last video, and I'll put a link to that in the description box, a lot of this has been inspired by Rebecca Blair's work. Some of the patterns, definitely. Some of them are, I say, my own creations. I'm sure other people have used them. I don't know how many patterns there are that are truly unique. I'm sure there are many. But, ones that came out of my own nogging. But I'm sure, I'm sure other people have made them, used them in one way or another. It's an infinite number of patterns anyway, so I'm going to do the same with these triangles, top, bottom, and then I've got these ones in between, which could lend me something interesting to do. I could either put a single colour there. I'm tempted actually to put colour just on one side, so we have shadow on one side to give some dimension, and I can then add lines to this to vary the intensity of the shadow perhaps. I don't know. I'll look at it in a moment when I finish this. Ooh, tight squeeze there. I really like the bullet nibs on these. I find them easier to manage than brush nibs. So that's quite fun. I do think it needs some colour there, but I'm not sure what colour. For now, I'm going to leave it. I don't think I want to put sandstone there, and I've used the ivory where it is. Okay, a couple of other pieces. This one, I'm going to use caramel to the left and bottom, so we've got that in shadow. Try and don't be so heavy-handed, please, Angela. Like so. So that's starting to give some, but I do want some. A little bit of shadow, perhaps on side. Possibly. Can have a bit there. So, actually, I think I'll put it on the top as well, because I think that would make some sense then. That'll be alright. So that's added some interest there. This one I'm going to, I've been trying to think how I'll do that one, but I think my best bet is to actually put lines of colour perhaps that go, let me have a look, I've got sandstone here, so I think I may use sandstone just to fill in the bottom. Now I'm going to go right to the edge of the panel, come back and go across. Again. I really like this pattern. Said it's inspired by archaeological maps with site plans to show gradients. Which way the land slopes, and then I'm going to come back with the ivory and just use that perhaps to get a gradient going. Just to bleach some of this, the black is moving because I've put alcohol marker over it. So that started to reactivate some of the pigment, sadly, but it'll be fine. And then I'm just going to go here, and perhaps I will just little bits in as I go along. Use the tops of the lines as my guide. And then I've got that there. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use some of the caramel. I'm going to put a darker edge at the bottom here. I'm just going to take it below. Still going to leave a border there. And just the caramel going across like that. In fact, I might take it down right down to the line there. That would make some sense. And then I'll come back with the sandstone on along the edge here just to help that to blend. That actually works nicely, I like that. That's worked better than I thought it would. Tell you what, the colours look much browner, reddier browner on the screen than they are for me here. I can tell you that much. Interesting. Function of the camera. Okay, so I've got a couple more sections to do. I've got the sandstone in my hand, and how I did this one is how I'm tempted to do this, but I think I'm just going to colour some in with sandstone. I may come back with caramel because I think the caramel shows up, doesn't it, as different. Said it's subtle, but I prefer subtle because I can always intensify that if I want to. And I'm going to leave these flat colours. And I'm going to do some in the caramel. The slower you colour or you add the ink, the more that will flow into the paper, so the darker colour you get as well. Because this paper's slightly absorbent, so. Also a good reason to use my other marker paper because it doesn't use up so much ink. Got that one. And then all the others I think I'm going to just fill in with the ivory. Even if, there's some sections that are next to each other, but there's that caramel one. There's that one there. Put caramel there as well and that'll be fine. They're not exactly next to each other, as it were. So I've got a range of interesting colours going on there. This one. I'm going to leave that one because I think I'm going to do that a bit like Knightsbridge. This one here though, I really want to add darkness in here, and I'm going to do to the top and the right so it looks like these are hollowed, where I can get a rightened top in. Can't always. And then I'm going to use the sandstone to go over this. Gosh, my hands are sweating. I'm so warm. I will open a window soon. Jeepers. It's mostly medication, I think. The antidepressants I take do make me feel very hot. As in temperature wise, not any other connotation of that word. Is that the right word? Yeah. The Just going back and adding some more of the caramel now, just to go back and add, make these areas that little bit darker again. And I'm going to let it dry, and I'll come back when it's dry perhaps and add some more. But I know I'm going to be using pen in there. So this is really the underpainting, if you will. Okay, round the outside, I'm going to use the ivory on them. So I'm going to do a couple in ivory, and I'm going to then use the... come back, and I think I'll use the blender pen afterwards just to bleach some of this colour out. So I'll do a few, get my blender, and then I'm going to bleach it out where the highlights would be. You can actually do textures with this as well. Little dots or little lines and so on, it will bleach along those areas. I just want to put some here. In fact, I might just put some bleachy bleach in before I do anything, because that might help to spread it out before I do anything else. May not. I'm experimenting. Don't think it did, but it's no hassle to go back and just add some of the blender solution just to push the colour away. But again, I'm going to use the sandstone to add some shadow at the bottom of these shapes, because I think it'll be quite subtle anyway. So I'll just finish these, and of course, because of the background's black, don't have to worry about colouring inside the lines. Woohoo! Even with the bits in the centre, it's not going to make much of a difference. So I'm trying to think which one's just done. If I go over the others, ooh, look at that black just came out there. That'll be fine. Get the lid on the ivory for a moment. And then I'm going to use the sandstone on the left and bottom of these shapes. Bear in mind, this will fade as it dries, so even though it might look a bit clunky here at the moment, the colour becomes less intense on drying, just like watercolours do. I think is why I find watercolours so difficult to work with, because I think I've got a rich, intense colour, and when it dries you think, where's the colour all gone? I know you have to make it more intense than you think it does, but I still haven't worked that one out. So I am just going to go back and just round the, just touching the edge of these sections before they completely dry, the ivory, just to help the edge perhaps blend in and spread out that little bit more. And it will also darken the ivory that's down a little bit as well. And then we've got these which look like they've got little holes. And that's that. That's that all done. The in-between lines I'm going to leave white. Let me just pop these back in my in the box, because I don't want any more. Right, there we go. All done. Now then, you have to excuse the rattle of the pencil case, because I'm going to go hunting colours. That would actually be quite a nice colour to use, because it's quite a pale khaki colour. I've got a, yeah, I've got a greeny colour there. Ooh, that could be quite nice. I've got loads in this pencil case. That's a warm grey. Don't want that one. Ooh, the emotes. See, that would work quite nicely, because even though it's not a brown, I think it'll look really good. I don't want the greeny green, but I wouldn't mind a browny brown, as in something that's brownish. Let's have a look. Just a few more to go. I know you can't see them all because I'm such a pain in the bottom here. That one, I think, would be... Actually, I think that one... the green, that green away. I'm looking for some soft browns. That soft brown would be nice. I think that colour might be as well. And then perhaps that one. I know they're green. Might keep that, actually that green might be nice. But I don't mind using a different colour on the top. And of course I've got my black ones out anyway, so that we're good to go with those. So I've got 10 minutes. 10 minutes, oh no! Let's attack some of these with my O1. Because what I'm going to do here with these, I'm going to draw a shape that just touches the outs, you know, the outer or the edge of the shadowed part, so that I'm creating something a bit like this here, but instead of starting by defining where I want to put these, I'm letting my ink do that for me, however my pens go. Take some of the pressure off me when I'm colouring. Wobbly lines are fine here because I've deliberately put wobbly lines in. Well, you can't put the whole shape in, you just put the line in. Okay, now let me have a look here. Because I can draw on the back. Look at this, I've got little bits of glitter everywhere for my pencil case. So the colours I've got are this one, which is actually, that's way too brown. That's too in my face for brown. I've got this one. Oh, that's a nice one. That will actually go nicely, which means this one most probably will. I think that'll do fine. This one hopefully isn't too garish. Oh, it's very subtle. They're not exactly the same colours, but they do tone in nicely. So I'm going to use the darkest colour here, and I'm just going to put some cross-hatched lines in this colour in the middle of these, just to darken it down, and it makes everything look a bit different, not so samey. Just as simple as that, tiny little cross-hatch lines. These are just below 0.88 pens. They're actually fine, 0.4 fine liners. The ink in them is water soluble, it's water based, so it's great for putting on top of things if you're going to be using wet media. But I found that a very light, just barely damp brush can create interesting effects where you still get some of the dark line there, but the colour blends in with, you know, the background or whatever else you're adding. And I find that quite an interesting effect on paper that will take it. This won't take any water at all. It pills and collapses almost instantly. The packaging says for all kinds of markers. It doesn't need to specify all kinds of alcohol markers or permanent markers. So I think a lot of people are getting caught out with thinking it'll be suitable for things like Tombows and the Zig real brush pens, Kuretake Zig real brush pens, something like that, and other similar ones. It's okay for drawing with these because I'm not going to be going back and forth and scribbling with them. I'm using it to put texture on. So here, oh, I went on the sandstone one. I'm fine with that. Perhaps I'll do, yeah, it'll be all right. Because the background colour changes the tone of this pen because the ink is transparent. With pigment pens, they're opaque, semi-opaque. I'll use the middle-toned one for the sandstone, but I want to do this in a different direction, so I'm going to take whichever side of the shapes appeals to me and aura that shape. Got some more here. I'm taking the slanted side, like so, and like so. That helps to change the feeling of those. And then the ivory one, I'm just going to put a line round like this, as if there's a shadow there. Perhaps this colour isn't the best one for this, but, you know, it'll do. And as these dry, they will hopefully fade as well. So that's quite nice. Now, this one here, I want to do a bit like Knightsbridge, but I'm going to do it like little teeth as well. So I'm going back and just splitting these in half diagonally. And I think to help tie these weird colours I'm using in, I may use those to fill underneath this gap, particularly I'm gonna use that darker colour, because I think that will work quite nicely there. It is a darker colour than the darkest marker I used, so. Go. It's just a different kind of pattern. They're all really quite simple. They just look complex when you put them together, but I do like creating samplers like this. This is going to find its way into my Entangled sampler book. I'll mount it on a piece of paper, perhaps do some patterns around that. I may colour the paper that goes underneath with distress inks then, so we've got something different from behind it. Trying to add colour as neatly as I can. I'm not a fan of adding colour with felt tip pens, but I'm trying it. But if I use these colours elsewhere, you know, right the way through, then it's all going to tie in. I'm not happy with these shapes here that I did with the lightest colour in these. And so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I'm going to turn them into filler patterns. So I'm just going to join them to the sides and just aura the lines so that we get a different kind of filler pattern going on there. Not ideal, but I'm happier with this. That stands out as being very different to the other bits, and it doesn't feel like they fit in terms of patterning. So very simple, but it works. And I'm happier with that. And of course that background colour does show through. This is going to be an awkward one, but I'm just going to put it across and it'll be fine. Now that I feel much better with. I'm happier with that. I am. And the patterns, the darker colours on top, they actually help to bring out the contrast, don't they? Fabulous. Fabulous. Right, on this one, I'm hoping that this will be an interesting effect, because this colour is going to go from light to dark, so this colour should look interesting as I draw on this. And I'm just going to draw an aura inside these. Nothing more, nothing less. A little bit of something to add, a little bit of interest in that. I may live to regret it. There is such a thing as overworking, and I love this just as it is, as it was, but I think sometimes you've just got to try. And the worst thing that will happen is the next time I do this, I'll go, no, don't do that, Angela, you didn't like it last time. Hopefully I'll remember. I'm not going to hold my breath on that one. How many times have you heard me say about colours? Monochrome's best for me as I go crazy with them. I try yet again watercolours and go, why do I do that? Actually, I like that. I think you do a couple and you think, oh, what was I thinking? You carry on and suddenly it comes together, so that's great. This one, around the outside of this, I'm going to use this and I'm trying to put little circles in, so a bit of tipple though I think little lines might have been better. So we'll do that on the other ones, or perhaps alternate them and make a variation in pattern out of them. Just helps to actually know, perhaps I just need to, yeah, I'm going to add some. I don't like colouring things in, says she who's going to now. There's some pattern in that though, because I've already put those lines down, it'll be fine. I mean, I can always come back over with patterns once I've finished these, they'll stand out. Because again, the colours add, just like the alcohol markers will add one on top of the other and intensify the colour. Increase the saturation of the colour, the depth of the colour. There's a different size of these pens. I think they're called 0.68. I could be wrong, but they've got a thicker fibre tip point on them. The colours are exactly the same in the sets, which is nice. I do like them. I like the Staedtler Triplus as well. And they're very pleasant to work with as well. The Artezas are okay, but their colours are really bright. There's not very many subtle colours that I like. So that's a bit of a disappointment. But they're not too expensive, really, in the grand scheme of things. I'm not sure if you can buy the colours open stock. You certainly can with most of the Staedtler Triplus. I'm still waiting on an order I put back on the 6th of April with a company. I sent them an email 2 days ago saying, oi, what's up with my order? I placed it, you've had the money since the 6th of April and I still haven't had my goods. Have I had a reply? The answer to that is no. Okay. All right, so those I'm going to leave as they are. These I'm going to leave as they are. This one, I'm going to use the darker colour of these to fill in one side. Hopefully it won't take me too long. It's going to, because we're getting to bigger ones here, so I need to get a wiggle on. Actually, the flowers, I might put some texture in, perhaps. I don't know yet. I'll see. Might just put some dots in, colour, like pollen on the petals. Oh no! What I've just done. Okay, it's right slap bang in the middle. So let's put the darker side on the opposite side for the rest of them. Well, I say slap bang in the middle, it's near as middle as I'm going to get it. So what comes when you're thinking about something else, not paying attention to what you're doing? It's fine. Can't do anything about it now. All I can do is to do something so the so what I did on one side, I do on the other side. So that'll work. And then I'll use the lightest colour. Fill in the white side, because I don't like the white on its own. And I want something that will help the little flowers stand out. Now, maybe I go back with a medium colour with these, but let's have a look. What I might do is put some black lines in the top and bottom triangles, just to darken those down. The ones at the top and the bottom of this ribbon. Colouring's not very good. I'm trying to rush because I know I'm most probably well over an hour. Oh yeah, 1 hour and 4 minutes. There. I think I might just use a fine black pen, and I'm just going to put some fine black lines in here. It's all got the colour behind them, but the black, your eye sort of mixes the colours together and you get that feeling that this is more in shadow, darker than the other sections. It may not be perfect. Goodness knows I'm not perfect. These are always an experiment, and sometimes I think, oh, what am I thinking? And then I'll come back when I finish this, because I am going, what on earth possessed me to do this? And once I finish it, I might go, actually, that's not too shabby. Desperate for a cup of tea as well, so I will be finishing soon. I really need some tea. May make a video tomorrow because I've been very lax keeping up with my social media in the last 2-3 weeks, perhaps longer, because I run out of energy very quickly still. Lot to contend with, a lot of healing still going on, both physically with my back and now tonsillitis, but also emotionally and mentally. And really do run out of energy and focus. So that actually isn't too shabby. This one here, I want to do some, I don't know what I want to do with this one. It does look a bit odd in the middle, but it is what it is now, and I can't do anything about that. Okay, I said I was going to put perhaps some dots here. I think I might use, I actually might just use a black and just perhaps scatter some dots around on the petals. Ones and groups of threes, just to give those some interest. Try not to make it identical. They don't even have to be in the same part of the petal. And perhaps I've overdone it. So I will leave some of them with perhaps things a little bit different, perhaps not so many areas with these in. She says doing all of them now. That'll be all right. Pop one in there because you can't have odd even numbers. So yeah, it's fine. I may go over those with gold. This one, I'm just going to add some lines that I flick down from the top, getting longer as I get to the right. So it's sort of echoing that shadow just to give an extra hint of darkness there. Vaguely following the shape of the shadow I've put in. Don't have to be precise or exact. It's just suggesting there's some shadowing going on. So that adds to that. And I'm just going to put some little rows of stippling at the bottom and left. Again, over where that shadow is. Not entirely the whole way though, but just enough along the edge, perhaps in that bottom left hand corner the most, just to give that variation in colour and shading. Might have overcooked this one as well, but I'll leave some as they are, because if this is a sampler, I do want to leave them and perhaps come back at a later date and decide, do I like them with the stippling in or not? These, I'm just going to put lines through the middle of the flowers. Now, I didn't do this when I drew them because I knew I'd be using alcohol markers, and I knew that if I put too many lines here, I would end up with a lot of black smudginess. As it is, I haven't had much black smudginess, which is rather cool. Okay, that one is fine as it is. So that's all of that. Okay, last thing, pencil. My other pencil case. So I have two new types of white gel pen. Got the other one. So I do have my Sakura jelly rolls, but I've also got this Pilot Choose 07. It's a pigment gel pen. So that means this ink is fairly opaque and it's permanent when it dries. Jelly rolls aren't permanent when they dry. The Sakura Soufflés are. And this is a Pentel Hybrid Gel DX. And again, the DX means it's document safe ink. So this is pigment ink. And it is permanent once it's dried. So I'm going to use this to add some dots at the top of these where the highlights would be, just to help to bring some highlights out. This one's quite broad. I think it's a 1 millimeter ball, but that's the size of the ball, but I think it's a 7 millimeter, a 0.7 millimeter line, possibly. The other one is a 0.7 ball, but it's much finer than that. I'm going to put some white in the middle of my petals there. Here, I'm just going to put some white where we've got the lightest colour there, because the alcohol markers will have darkened the paper. So I'm putting two dots on either side of the lines as I go zigzaggy fashion almost. Let's go up the diagonals. When they dry, they'll dry nicely opaque white and we'll have those hints of lightness here, which is what we want. It's that little hint that there might be a bit of sparkle. Don't know how well they're showing up. It's very subtle, but it's there. Okay, I've got these to do. I think that's all of those. Oh. Along here, I'm actually going to draw a white line right down the middle to break those curves up. I'm going to take it, I'm taking it over the black line, but I can come back and draw that in. So it cuts through those little arcs as if they're shining. Some of the black may show through because although it's opaque, it's not totally opaque. Okay, these ones, and some of them, I'm going to fill these in with a white shape that echoes the shape of the piece I'm filling in. I'm not going to do this with the ivory ones. I'm going to leave those just with the darker ones. These don't look very white, because essentially they're not. They do pick up some of the alcohol marker, it seems. But my back of my hand is going white with it, because I find that's the best way to get my pen working properly. With these ones, I'm going to put white dots at the middle of each of these shapes. That one's too small for me to try. So I'm just going to leave it. I might try with the finer white gel pen in a moment. This one I'm going to leave them as they are. This one, I'm going to leave those as they are, I think. This one's got a highlight there. Okay, let's try with the finer one in places. Skin sometimes is the best thing to get this working. So I am going to put a line of white inside these shapes. It's going to pick up some of this colour, so it's going to be a lighter version of it. And I'm fine with that. Because the ink that I've used here isn't permanent, it is water soluble, it will pick it up. I'm not sure what the solvent is that they use for this pigment ink. It'll work. I'm not going to do anything to those because they've got plenty of interesting stuff going on. I do want to add something here, and I think it's going to be around this side. So around the left and bottom a little bit, as if this lip here is just that little bit higher. So it'll be opposite, sort of like the imagined shady area inside this. So it's just going to give that hint of highlight there. Like so. Okay, now then, the last thing I want to do is this one. And I think I'm just going to put a dot, or three, big one at the bottom and two little ones above, in each of these, just to add some interest there. I mean, it is interesting as it is, but sometimes it's just nice to break up the black. And if the little shapes are too small to get three dots in, whatever you can get in. Hopefully nobody's going to count. Some of them I can only get one in, others I can only get two in. So I'm fine with whatever they are. One good thing about it being very warm in my room is this pen dries quickly. The chances of smudging are much lower. That's added a little bit of something to that, isn't it? And I think the white has added something there. Might just go over the top of these with perhaps little dots of white if I can. So perhaps there's a little bit of black shadow underneath the white. That actually works quite nicely. I think that was quite a genius idea, Angela. How did you come up with that one? Dunno. Actually is working right nicely. I wasn't happy with those black dots. They were a bit stark against the pale colour. But this suggests those little hints of black just sticking out suggest that these white dots have some volume to them. It's tricky to get your pen exactly where these are, but if they get covered up, they get covered up. The white will still show a little bit. I'm going to have to come in from a different side so I can get these done. Hopefully I haven't put my hand in damp ink. No. Okay. So I'll put some white in some of the areas without the black underneath. I can still see the white there, but it's subtle, whereas that black really helps it stand out. It's that hint of it underneath. It's like we've got little dots of white pollen. Okay, the last thing I'm going to do, because I think I'm done. I say I think I'm done because it is only thinking, because I've got to work out what I want to do with these borders, is I am going to add my initial here. My initials. And I like to put them in a little, almost like a coin, it's tucked underneath the artwork, just like that. And I'm just going to thicken this bottom line, and I'm going to make it a messy thickening so I don't have to be quite so precise. And I'm actually going to do the same down the side, so I've got some extra thick lines down the left and bottom, which will give the impression that this has perhaps some volume to it as well. So it's not just thin and flat, there's some dimension there. Has a little bit of height. And it's imperfect because I'm learning to be okay with imperfect lines. If I make them deliberately this way, then who's going to argue with me? Somebody will. But that is this all done. So I'll turn it on its side, because it doesn't matter which way up it is, because it should, you know, whichever way you like it, it works. And I hope you've enjoyed this. That's now finished. I'm not doing any more to it. It's done. I think I might leave the separating bars as they are, or I might go back and add some subtle black patterns, you know, like dots and like shatterk or something like that. Or I might, you know, might find an alcohol marker that will suit me there, but I actually quite like it just as it is. So thank you for joining me on this mammoth video today. 1 hour and 20 minutes, for goodness sakes. And I hope to see you again. And if you do one of these and you share it on social media, don't forget to tag me. On Instagram, I'm at Angela Porter Artist, I think it is. I think there's little down lines, you know, little bottom dashes, underscores between Angela Porter Artist. It might be Angela Porter Artwyrd, I can't remember. On Facebook, you can find me as Angela Porter or Artwyrd. Artwyrd is my Facebook page, which I rarely ever visit, so there. You can find me on Twitter. I'm Artwyrd on Twitter, or Angela Porter. I don't Twitter much. Or leave a comment. Let me see. I'd love to see what you do. So thank you so much for joining me. Please look after yourselves, and I will see you again soon. And find time to be creative. Bye for now. Bye. Bye.